Harold Shapiro, Lois Gordon, you stand together in the presence of God. At this, the holiest hour of your lives, open your hearts to the sanctity of this ceremony, which unites you in holy matrimony. Baruch haba, bruch haba, bruchim haboim b'shem Adonai. Hodu Adonai ki tov, ki lo olam chasdov. Blessed be ye who come before this altar of marriage in the name of God. Mi adir al hako, mi boruch al hako, mi godol al hako, yvorech es hechason v'yasakala. Lord our God, at this sacred hour we ask thy blessing upon this bride and groom. Guide them through every trial and temptation. In thy grace, join them unto each other with a love that shall not falter. And cause them to approach this holy ceremony of marriage with understanding and with reverent hearts. Harold and Lois, you stand here not only in the presence of your dear ones and your friends, but you stand in the presence of your God. This is not just a ceremony constituted in terms of words and prayers and blessings, but this is what we of the Jewish faith call kiddushin, holiness. In the Talmud, our rabbis pondered the meaning of the prayer you have heard so many times. Kadosh, kadosh, kadosh Adonai Tzavos, Melech Kol Haaretz Kavodo. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is filled with his glory. The rabbis ask, what does this mean? How is God's glory revealed upon earth? Is God's glory revealed through wondrous miracles? Is it revealed through supernatural manifestations of nature? Is God's holiness revealed as the rabbi lifts his voice in prayer to God? The answer of the rabbis is beautiful and magnificent in its simplicity and in its truth. And they say that when a man and a woman join their hearts together in consecrated love, their marriage is the holiness of God upon earth. You have the power then, through your love and through your marriage, to bring divinity, to bring something of holiness into this world. That is why marriage is called Kiddush and holiness. And that is why a Jewish home is not called a castle, but a mikdash ma'at, a little sanctuary. It is not to be thought of in terms of walls or furniture or dimensions, but it is a house of God. And because it is a house of God, it must be filled with love and tenderness and beauty and truth. And above all, holiness. Our rabbis tell us that there are four pillars that support the Jewish home: husband and wife, God and love. If there is love, there is God. And with these four pillars, a home stands strong. And even though assailed by all the winds of circumstance, it cannot be shaken. But if love should leave your home, and God should leave your home, then your home will be weak, and it cannot stand. As I look at you standing before me, knowing that your hearts are filled with love, I, along with your dear ones and your friends, have every confidence that your home will be filled with the presence of God. And as your wedding text, I give you that beautiful statement from our Bible. When Abraham took his son Isaac, they went up the mountain of Moriah, and it was said of them, Vayelchu shnehem yachdov. The two of them walked together. If you remember nothing else of this ceremony, Harold and Lois, I want you to remember these words. The two of them walked together. And as you walk together through life, meeting joy and sorrow, in sickness and health, through prosperity and adversity, you can never be alone. Your love will triumph over every obstacle because you will walk together. Walking together, meeting life together, you will personify holiness throughout what we hope will be a long and a happy life. I want you to look at each other for a moment. As you look at each other, you see more than a man, more than a woman, more than male, more than female. You say, as Adam said, this is flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone. This is yours, not as a monopoly, not as possession, but this is yours to love, to cherish, to protect throughout life. And at this moment of holiness, as you think only of the meaning and significance of your marriage, as a servant of God, I invoke his presence here, saying, Adonai, Adonai, El Racham V'Chanan, Mekadesh U'Mevorech Es Hechason V'Es Hakala, O Lord God, Thou who art gracious and merciful, guide and bless this bride and groom we have called. May his answer be revealed upon the tablets of your hearts as you speak one to another, saying, the two of them walk together now and forevermore. And now, standing here in the presence of God, ready to enter into the bond of wedlock, answer in the awe of God, and in the hearing of this assembly, Harold Shapiro, do you of your own free will and consent take Lois Gordon to be your wife, and do you promise to love, honor, and cherish her throughout life? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Lois Gordon, do you of your own free will and consent take Harold Shapiro to be your husband, and do you promise to love, honor, and cherish him throughout life? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Baruch atu Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam, Jacob bara lichvodo. Baruch atu Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam, Yotzer ha'adam. Baruch atu Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam, Asher yotzar esu ha'adam b'tzalmo. B'tzalem demus tavni so v'chizkin lo mimenu binyan adeyad. Baruch atu Adonai, Yotzer ha'adam. Baruch atu Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam, Asher bara sason v'simcha, chason v'chala, Gila rina ditza v'chedva, Ahava v'yachava shalom v'reus. Sameach tzamach, Reim ho'ahuvim, V'yizku livnos bayis b'yisroel, L'shem v'lisehila, V'yishalom v'veisam v'shava v'ashket v'libosam, V'yiru b'nechamas Yisroel, V'yisashuas olam baruch atu Adonai, M'sameach chosen im hakala. Now give up your bride to drink. Baruch atu Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, borei pri hagafen. You drink of it? Praise be thou, God, King of the universe, who has created the fruit of the vine. As you have shared the contents of this cup together, so may you share the contents of the cup of life, and may it be filled to overflowing with health, with happiness, with holiness, and with love. A ring? Now place this ring upon the finger of your bride as token of wedlock, and repeat the words which I now say. Be thou consecrated unto me.
Be thou consecrated unto me.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As my wife.
As my wife.
According to the faith of Israel.
According to the faith of Israel.
Harayat.
Harayat.
Mekudeshesli.
Mekudeshesli.
V'taba'azu.
V'taba'azu.
Kadas Moshe.
Kadas Moshe.
V'Yisroel.
V'Yisroel.
And Alois, place this ring upon your groom's finger as token of wedlock, and repeat these words. Be thou consecrated unto me.
Be thou consecrated unto me.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As my husband.
As my husband.
According to the faith of Israel.
According to the faith of Israel.
Now as these rings are round and without end, so may your love and devotion to each other be everlasting, eternal, and without end. Baruch atu Adonai, Mekadesh Amo Yisrael, Al Yedei Kiddushin. Praise be thou, O God, who sanctifiest thy children by the holy covenant of marriage. Now that you have spoken the words and performed the rites which unite your lives, as a rabbi in Israel, I do hereby, in conformity with the faith of Israel and the laws of our state, declare your marriage to be valid and binding, and I pronounce you Harold Shapiro and you, Lois Gordon Shapiro, to be husband and wife before God and before man. Bow your heads. As I invoke upon you the threefold benediction of our faith, Yivorecha Bo Adonai V'Yishmerecha. May the Lord bless thee and keep thee. Yoer Adonai Punov Elecha V'Yichonecha. May the Lord let his countenance shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. Yisa Adonai Punov Elecha, V'yosem Lecha Shalom. May the Lord God, in his infinite mercy, lift his face unto you, Harold and Lois Shapiro, and grant unto you health and happiness, life and love and peace. And may it be said of you, now and always, the two of them walk together. May God bless you and keep you and grant you the holiness and the consecrated love of marriage now and forevermore. Amen. Kiss your bride. Mazel tov and congratulations.
Okay. We are about to listen to the wedding ceremony at the marriage of Lois Marie Gordon and Harold Shapiro. The wedding took place at Temple Emmanuel, Duluth, Minnesota, commencing at 8 p.m. on the evening of Sunday, July 30, 1950. Rabbi William B. Silverman, the spiritual leader of Temple Emmanuel, officiated. The soloist is Mrs. David Deutsch, and she is accompanied on the organ by Mrs. Sam Popkin. The maid of honor is Miss Marilyn Gordon of New York City, cousin of the bride. And the bridesmaids are Miss Helen Scharf of New York City, cousin of the groom, and Mrs. Bert Schwartz of Hibbing, Minnesota. The groom's brother, Marvin, is his best man, and Leslie Shapiro, Harvey Solon, Ray Johnson, Raymond Scharf, and Dr. Bert Schwartz are the ushers. The bride was given away by her father, Harry Gordon, and the groom was attended by his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Bert Shapiro. It is a lovely evening in Duluth, and the temple is filled to capacity. The candles are lighted on the candelabras on both sides of the altar by the ushers, Dr. Schwartz and Harvey Solon. The white carpet is rolled on the aisle by the ushers. And the rabbi then mounts the altar, followed by the groom and his best man. The bridesmaids then proceed down the aisle, followed by the maid of honor, and preceded by the groom's grandfather on the arm of his grandson, Leslie Shapiro, then followed by the parents of the groom. The bride, in her beautiful white wedding gown, then follows on the arm of her father. She is preceded down the aisle, as stated before, by the maid of honor, and as she mounts the altar and all take their places, Rabbi Silverman proceeds with the wedding ceremony. We shall now hear the soloist, Mrs. Deutsch, singing the bridal song.